Hey everyone, Kevin Mitchell here, and I hope you're ready for Fired Up Fridays, because in this rant today, I'm going to be talking to you about how we raise our children. Being a father of two boys, it's a real passion of mine, and I think we can do a lot better job as a society raising our children. They're our future, they're so important to us, and I love this article that I'm talking about associated with this video, because it talks about three really important things, and I'm going to go through each one quickly here. First, we risk too little. That's what he titles it. And what it means is, with our kids, when you are always trying to help your kids, prevent them from failing, telling them not to take chances, you know, stopping them from making mistakes and sometimes hurting themselves a little bit, we are really doing a ton of damage to our kids, guys. Failure is one of the most important aspects of life. It's one of the most important determining factors to people that succeed. Those that succeed the most fail the most. I know it sounds crazy, but failure teaches so much more than success. When we're always risk averse, when we risk too little, we prevent our children from learning the necessary lessons in life that's needed. Life's tough, man, and if we don't teach our children how tough life is and how to fail, they are going to be in for a world of hurt when the real world hits them. Sometimes that's 19, sometimes that's 25, sometimes that's 45, depending on the kid. But ultimately, real life is going to smack 99.9% of us in the mouth at some point in our life. And if you continually raise your kids by not allowing them to risk, not allowing them to fail, you're setting them up for unreal expectations and not being able to learn from their failures and really not being able to know what life's about. So let your kids fail. Let them risk. Let them live life to learn these lessons. And I can think of one thing in my life. We have a year and a half year old son, and we have an in-ground pool. And I'm always letting him walk around the pool when I'm down there with him. And it's funny because Lindsay and I, my wife, talked lots of times. She said, "What? Don't, you know, make sure life jackets on him. Don't let him walk around like that." And it's like, no, let him walk around. I'm right here. I'm looking at him, and if he falls in by risking, by maybe grabbing a pool noodle, he's going to learn really quickly the cause and effect of, you know, failing to stay on the sidewalk instead of falling in the pool. So let's take this lesson, guys. It's really important. Allow your kids to fail, even sometimes when you know they are, as they get older, 10, 11, 12, teenage years. If it's not going to drastically hurt them, you have to be willing to let your kids fail. Secondly, we rescue too easily. When kids are failing, don't sit there and pull their ass out of the fire right away. Let them suffer. Let them experience the consequences of their actions. Again, I know it's so tough being a dad. I get it. But if we don't step back sometimes and let our kids face the consequences of their actions, again, they're not going to succeed at life because they think that you're or somebody's always going to be there to pull them out of this predicament they're in. Obviously, all these rules and these lessons have, you know, there's exceptions to them, but by and large, don't rescue your kids too early. If they're failing a test, if they go ahead and get, you know, maybe sat a period for hockey for not trying in hockey, or if they fail a test in school or whatever, or if they maybe get detention for doing something, don't go in there and fight their battles. Coach them, help them figure it out themselves. Don't rescue your kids. And lastly, we rave too easily. And this is huge. Oh my God, this is huge. Because if you rave too much, your words become hollow. It's thou doth protest too much. That's a great saying. And what it means, and God bless my mother, she's watching today. My mom raves and has raved about me and my brother Eric since the time we've been, you know, as long as I can remember. And ultimately, and unfortunately, because she raves about everything and talks about how great we always look, how great we are at sports, how great we are at this and that, her words ring hollow with me because I sometimes know it's like, you know, I know I've put on an extra 15 pounds. I don't look that good right now, mom. Or, you know, I play a bad game of hockey. She's telling me how great I am. It's like, no, compliment your kids. Rave about them when they have a great game of hockey. Rave about them when they do really well. And you know something, a great game of hockey or a great game of baseball to them might simply, you know, not stepping out of the box when they swing the bat or. The ultimately is, when you're proud of your kids, when they've done a great job, rave to high heaven. When they haven't, don't kiss their ass. Tell them they could have done better. Tell them that, yeah, their effort was all right, but ultimately they have better. Honest, pure feedback is so much better than this bullshit ass kissing that goes on in society today. Again, we're not doing them any favors. Because if you tell them they do great, and they did great when they didn't do great, you're again not letting them experience life as it's meant to be experienced, and at some point it's gonna smack them right in the face. There it is, that's my Fired Up Fridays. I hope you enjoyed, and I look forward to talking to you soon.